Hello students, in this module we'll learn about the climate of India and we'll begin with the factors affecting climate. As we have learned just now that the factors that affect the climate of any place, we should know about them first, then only we can understand the rest of the climatic condition of that place in a better way. So let's proceed. These are the list of factors that affect the climate of India specifically. Let's read them. Locational extent across the Tropic of Cancer, influence of Himalayas, relief, distance from sea, altitude, upper air current, jet stream, and the effect of monsoon. So students, there are 7 in the list and we'll learn about them one by one and we'll see how they affect the climate of the country. So the first one in the list is the latitudinal extent of the country and the Tropic of Cancer. If we see this map, it's clearly understood that the Tropic of Cancer passes almost from the center of the country. Therefore, if we recall of the heat zones, we can understand that the northern part of the country experience temperate type of climate or subtropical climate, whereas the southern portion to the south of Tropic of Cancer lies in the torrid zone or tropical zone. So this experience tropical type of climate. Therefore, as the Tropic of Cancer is passing from the center of the country, so this has divided the country into 2 different heat zones, or we can say the northern and the southern part of the country lies in 2 different heat zones. This map will further make it clear that the northern half experience subtropical climate, whereas the southern portion experience tropical climate because it is near the equator. And students, if we learn where the equator is, so we can say that the southern part of India, from there 8 degree 4 minute north latitude is passing. So equator is very close to the southern part of the country. Therefore, the Tropic of Cancer from there till the southern tip of the country lies in the torrid or tropical zone. The next factor affecting the climate is the altitude. So let's learn about it. Altitude or high relief, that is height above sea level. So students, we know that as we move up with height, the temperature drops. What is the rate of decrease in temperature? With every 165 meter of ascent, that is as we move every 165 meters above, there is decrease in 1 degree Celsius of temperature. Let's recall it. As we move up, with every 165 meters of height, there is drop in 1 degree Celsius of temperature. So students, do you remember what do we call this? Yes, we call this normal lapse rate. So how does this altitude affect the climate of India? If we see the map of the country, in the north we have mountains, then plains, and in the southern part there are plateaus. Now students, there is a lot of variation in the topography. There are high mountains as well as low-lying plains as well as plateaus also. Therefore, the higher the places with higher altitude, they experience lower temperature because of the lapse rate, whereas the low-lying areas, they, in spite of being at the same latitude, experience comparatively higher temperature because they are at lower altitude. So this is how there are several hill stations, hilly areas and mountainous regions in India which experience lower temperature because of their high altitude, whereas the plain areas, the low-lying areas at the same latitude, they experience higher temperature comparatively because of their low altitude. So this is how the altitude affects the climate of India. Now students, the third factor in the list is the role of the Himalayas. So let's see the location. Students, you can see here, this is the Himalayas. Himalayas extend all over the northern part of the country and continues up to northeast. So Himalayas consist of three parallel ranges. The highermost, known as Himadri Himalayas, then the middle, that is up to 6,000 meters of relief, the Himalaya is known as Himachal Himalayas, and the lower Himalayas are known as Shivaliks. So there are three parallel ranges of Himalayas, and you know, students, they affect the climate of India to a greater extent. So how do they affect? Let's learn about them. So the first one is, you can see the arrows, they are depicting the cold wind coming from the Arctic region or from the Siberian region. We call them cold Siberian wind. So during winter, the cold Siberian wind proceed towards India, but the Himalayas act like a barrier and they do not allow the cold Siberian winds to enter the country, and in this way, the wind during winters, India remain comparatively warmer than the rest of the Asia or to the north of the Himalayas. The reason is that Himalaya act as a barrier and do not allow the cold winds to enter India, and therefore India remains, it doesn't become very, very cold during winters. Otherwise, what would happen? India would have become frozen during winters. Now Himalayas has much more effect than this. So let's learn about it. This next effect of Himalaya is that the winds that cross the equator and proceed towards India as southwest monsoon, when they reach to the northern part, they come across the Himalaya. The Himalaya act as a barrier. And students, if you remember about the rain shadow effect, which we have learnt in the previous modules, so Himalaya act as a rain shadow barrier, and this is the reason the wind that enters and reaches here in the states of Bihar, Bengal, Uttar Pradesh, it causes good amount of rainfall. Heavy rainfall occur because Himalaya act as a rain shadow barrier and do not allow the rain bearing winds to move to the other side, and therefore good amount of rainfall occurs in the North Indian plain, and the states receiving good amount of rainfall are Bihar, Bengal, West Odisha, as well as Uttar Pradesh. So like this, students, Himalaya plays a very significant role in modifying the climate of India. So here in the list, the next factor is jet streams and the upper air circulation. The jet streams are band of fast moving wind in the upper part of the troposphere. These jet streams, they blow at a very high altitude, but due to the high altitude of the Himalayas, they get bifurcated into two branches. They are also responsible to attract the western disturbances that originate in the Mediterranean Sea and Atlantic Ocean. So here we can see in this diagram that the western cyclonic disturbances that originate in the Mediterranean Sea and in the Atlantic Ocean are attracted by the westerly jet stream. So jet streams are divided into two because of the high relief of the Himalayas, and this is known as subtropical westerly jet stream. This is responsible to bring the western disturbances in India. During summer, this jet stream blows as easterly jet stream, and it blows over the peninsular part of the country. As we discussed that the jet streams are responsible to bring the western disturbances. So what are western disturbances? They come from the west, so they are known as western disturbances. They are also known as westerly depressions. Now westerly because it's due to the westerly winds that come towards India, and it depressions means low pressure. Westerly depressions are used for to signify low pressure. So what happens in the Mediterranean Sea and Atlantic Ocean, these depressions, they arise, and then the westerly jet is responsible to bring these winds, moist winds, towards India, and on the way they cause rainfall, and parts of northwestern India receive rainfall during winter. We call it rainfall due to western disturbances or westerly depressions. So in this way, the jet streams, they affect the climate of. The next factor affecting the climate of India are the land breezes and sea breeze. So the land and sea breeze influence the climate of the coastal areas mostly. First, let us understand the concept. During the day, the land gets heated very quickly, whereas the sea takes a lot of time to get heated. Therefore, the land has high pressure, higher pressure compared to the land, and the land has higher temperature compared to the sea. As a result, the air above the land gets heated, rises up and moves towards the sea, and the cold wind over the sea is pushed towards the land. So during the day, when the cold wind blows from sea to land, we call it sea breeze. At night, just the opposite happens. The land cools down very quickly compared to the sea. So the wind blows from land to sea. The cold breeze blow from land to sea at night, and this is known as land breeze. So students, let us see how this phenomena affect the climate of India. See the coastal areas of India. So the coastal areas, India has a very long coastline. So the coastal areas are affected by the land breeze and the sea breeze, as they do not become very hot during the day and not very cold at night. Similarly, their summers are not very hot and their winters are not very cold. So the southern part of India, in spite of being in the torrid zone, the temperature of southern India and northern half of India doesn't have a big difference. The reason is the shape of the country. The country, if you see, the southern part has a tapering shape. The northern part is wide, where the southern part becomes narrow. Because of which, the southern, a large part of southern India lies close to the sea and comes under the influence of land breeze and sea breeze. As a result, the temperature is modified or moderated under the influence of the sea. Whereas North India, being very broad and very far from the sea, so it experiences continental type of climate. Whereas South India, most of South India, experience maritime or oceanic type of climate. As a result, northern and southern part of India, they do not have a big difference in temperature condition, in spite of South India being very close to the equator. So this is how the land and sea breeze influence, and it has a very big influence on the climate of India. Now students, the next factor is relief. So definitely high relief has a big influence on the climate of the country. So here is a diagram, and the concept here is of rain shadow effect, which we have already learned in the previous modules. So a high relief lying next to the sea, so the moist wind that will rise from the sea will condense to form cloud, and most of the rainfall will occur on the windward side, and the other side will remain comparatively dry. The other side is known as leeward side or rain shadow zone, whereas the side where rainfall occurs is known as windward side. So children, this is a phenomena of rain shadow effect, and it happens because of high relief. And if we see the map of India, there are a lot of places with high relief next to the sea. So we'll pick up the best example for you. So the best example is the Western Ghats. Students, when the southwest monsoon, you can see the arrows, These are the arrows showing the southwest monsoon winds. They are filled with moisture. They are rain-bearing winds. They can cause very heavy rainfall. So when these winds try to enter the continent, there lies Western Ghats, series of hills. So they pose a barrier to the path of the southwest monsoon winds, and this they act as a rain shadow barrier, causing very heavy rainfall on the western coastal plains of India. Whereas on the other side lies the Deccan Plateau. It is on the leeward side of the Western Ghats, so this receive very scanty rainfall. So if we compare both sides, the western side of the Western Ghats receive very heavy rainfall because Western Ghats act as a rain shadow barrier, whereas the Deccan Plateau on the leeward side receive very scanty rainfall. Now students, the next factor is monsoon. As I have told in the introduction, monsoon has a very vital and important role in the climate of India. It acts as an unifying factor. So if we see this map, from 20 degree north to 20 degree south, this area comes under the influence of monsoon. And ITCZ zone is the zone where both the trade winds, the northeast as well as the south east trade winds, they merge, they meet at ITCZ, intertropical convergence zone. We have learnt about this in the previous module. Now students, if we see the condition, this is the condition of India in summer. So in summer there is low pressure because of high temperature. So what happens, as we have learnt, wind blow from high pressure to low pressure. So surrounding seas will have high pressure compared to the land. So wind will start blowing from Arabian Sea, Bay of Bengal and even South China Sea towards the low pressure zone of Asia. So this will bring lot of rainfall all over India as well as in several other Asian countries surrounding India. We can see that this is the equator, and due to the Coriolis effect, as the south east trade winds cross the equator, they deflect from their path due to the Coriolis effect according to the Ferrell's law, and they become southwest monsoon. They enter India during summer months and they cause very good amount of rainfall almost in every part of the country. And you know what? Monsoon even changes its direction with the change in season. So they blow from southwest during summer in India, and during winter in India they start blowing from northeast, that is from land to sea. They are dry, but yet they cause little rainfall in the winter months in the states of Tamil Nadu and Andhra Pradesh. So like this, monsoon has a very important effect and role in modifying the climate of India. So students, here in this diagram you can see the winter condition. During winter, the condition just reverse, and the land has high pressure and the sea has low pressure. So during this time the wind blow from land to sea. As I told you just now, it while moving from land to sea, it crosses over Bay of Bengal for some time. It crosses over here and absorbs some moisture and causes rainfall in the coastal areas of Tamil Nadu and Andhra Pradesh. So like this, it has a monsoon has a big role in modifying the climate of India. These are the references. Thank you, student. That's all in today's class.